Hey, Kevin here with another Flippin' Dork Flips and Finds video where I show you different items to pick up really cheap, thrifting, garage selling, wherever. Basically buy stuff locally and then sell online, either on eBay and ship worldwide, or sell locally with Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist, different places like that. Anyway, wow, this week was awesome so far already. I found some really, really good stuff and I had a couple sales. Let me show you the sales real quick because I need to send them off first. All right, so I sold more laces, but check it out. I sold a pink pair this time. So the black and white ones have been doing well. All the laces I got for 50 cents each at Goodwill back over the winter. Anyway, the black pair here, black and white checkered, sold for $4.95 plus $3.70 shipping. So that's a total of $8.65. And because they're doing so well, I raised the price on the black and white ones. On all the others, I adjusted the price. Basically what I did is when I first posted them, everything was $6.75 free shipping. But then I realized that the black and white ones were selling so well, I wanted to raise the price. And then I messed around with the price on these, and I decided to do paid shipping. And then I could maybe make a little bit of money off of the shipping and still lower the price. So anyway, these, like the black and white ones sold for $4.95. The colored ones here, pink and black, sold for $3.50 plus $3.74 shipping. So that's a total of $7.24. So I was asking $6.75 free shipping, but now I changed it, and now they're selling for $7.24. So I'm making an additional 50 cents on them. So instead of profiting like $2.25, $2.50 per pair after they sell, now I'm gonna profit about $2.75, $3, something like that. So that's pretty cool. Okay, the other thing it sold is this right here. I actually completely forgot I had this. I found it the other day when I was cleaning up my downstairs room where I have tons of junk piled, and I've been going through it. It's kind of where I put my local items that sell. It's also where I keep my cardboard boxes and things like that. Anyway, I was going through double checking, seeing if I had everything listed, and I looked through this box of stuff. I was like, oh, wait a minute. I got a couple of remotes in there I need to list. So one of them here is this right here. It's a Sony video remote. I believe it's for a VCR. Model number is RMT-V306, and I just posted it like 2-3 days ago, and it sold for $11.95 free shipping. So that's not bad. I mean, you don't get a ton of money out of some remotes. Some can do all right. I think the most I ever got out of a remote was about $45, somewhere around there. I know some can go for crazy money, but I've never found amazing ones. But for the most part, you know, if one will make me, you know, will sell about $11, $12 free shipping or higher, I'll probably pick it up if it's really cheap. This one I got, if I remember right, I got it at a garage sale. I think it was the very first garage sale I ever went to back in 2017. So it's been a year and a half ago now. And it was like a weird backyard garage sale where you just piled everything and then they just gave you a price. Nothing was priced there. So I just piled stuff in a cooler, I think, if I remember right. Bought the cooler, I think I bought a plastic bucket. It was just all full of stuff, and I paid like 10 bucks. I've made my money back multiple times already, so I'm just considering this free. It's been sitting around so long, I don't have a record of when I actually bought it and all that kind of stuff. So I'm considering it a personal item in my records, and, you know, pure profit on whatever I make after shipping and after fees and all that kind of stuff. Okay, so that's what sold. I need to get them sent out, but let me show you what I picked up. I'll try to make it kind of quick. All right, so I bought this yesterday, but I want to save it for last because it's awesome. And then today I bought some things at Goodwill, and I met a guy for a deal I found on Facebook Marketplace last night. So let me explain that one first, because I got really pumped about it, and then it almost fell through, and then it worked out. So anyway, I was looking at, actually, yesterday afternoon, I was, where was I? I'm trying to remember how this worked now. Okay, we had something that we had sitting in a house, and it was a chair we had sitting around. It was nothing I was selling for reselling. We were just trying to get rid of it. And I sold it, and I had to meet the person at Walmart parking lot, all right? So when I went to go meet them, when I showed up, I went back on Facebook Marketplace, went to my messages, and let them know that I was there. And as I was logging in to Facebook Marketplace, these popped up. All right, so then I went and bought them. I'll explain that later. Then when I come home and double, how did that work? Okay, so I went to Walmart to meet for the chair. I found these, and then when I was contacting this guy about them, I found this item on Facebook Marketplace I'm talking about now. All right, so they just popped up. So what this is a whole bunch of Nintendo GameCube games. And, oh man, that'd be the second time I was dropping today. But anyway, there are nine, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, 9 games. And he just had a picture of all 9 of them sitting there, and it said, Nintendo GameCube games, $20. I thought, whoa, okay, wait a minute. Either, a lot of times on Facebook Marketplace, people are asking like almost eBay prices, so I figure, okay, he's probably asking like $20 a piece. Some of the games would still have been a decent buy because they're worth like double that. So I contacted, I didn't want to sound too excited or too interested. What really caught my attention was this particular game right here, because I sold this last year for 40 something dollars. All right, Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. I think it sold for like 40 or 42 or something like that. So I saw that, and he's only asking 20 bucks, so all the rest would be pure profit. So then I start going through eBay sold comps, looking them up. I was like, wow, that one's worth 20 bucks, that one's worth 25, that one's worth 30. I was like, is he asking 20 a piece or 20 for all of them? So I contacted them, I'm like, hey, are these still available? And immediately, he got back from me, yes. I thought, oh, no way. Okay, that's amazing. And anyway, so I got back with them. I was like, okay, great. Now, is there anything wrong with the games? Are they scratched up? Are they missing anything? And is the price for everything together? So I didn't want to sound too resellery, you know, whatever. And then he didn't get back with me for a while. I thought, uh-oh, you know, maybe I kind of turned this guy off, whatever. Well, then he got back with me, and he's like, yep, they're still available. Nothing wrong with them. I just haven't played my GameCube in forever. And yeah, I'm asking $20 for everything. I thought, no way. That's amazing. Okay. So I said, sure, I will take them. And, you know, I can meet anytime tomorrow. Because by the time I was talking to him, it was evening. It was raining. I didn't want to go drive out in it. And anyway, he's like, okay, yeah, sure, sounds good. And I said, well, let me know where you want to meet. He lives 30 miles away from me. I was like, I can meet you up somewhere in town, parking lot or whatever. It's easy to get to. Okay, yeah, sounds good. And then I waited a little bit, and I was like, I got back to him. I was like, well, what time could you meet? And then he gets back with me, and he sends a message. He's like, so it looks like I was asking too little for these. My phone has been blowing up with people asking about them, but because you were the first one, although there is another guy that offered me 40, I wanted to know if you were still interested. And I'm thinking, oh great, okay, that sucks. When I sell locally, I don't do that. If I made a mistake and someone agrees to a price, I just do it. I've learned the hard way on waiting on people, you know, and holding things, and then also settling on a price on it. You just don't do that. All right. So anyway, I didn't tell the guy that because I was thinking, well, okay, 40 bucks. All right. It's still an amazing deal because this game itself sells for more than 40 bucks. So I was like, okay, do I want to tell this guy, you know, how about 30? Well, then he's going to pass because there's some guy that lives in his town, you know, that's going to offer him 40 tomorrow. So I was like, I'll just do the 40. So I was like, sure. Yeah, I could do the 40. So when would you like to meet? Where would you like to meet? We finally set up a time. I meet him today and get him, and as he's handing them to me, and I said, $40, right? And he's like, yep. And I, you know, give him the money, and I'm looking at him. He's like, yeah, everyone was contacting me about him. He said they sell them for like hundreds of dollars, but I just don't have time to mess with them. I thought, you're lost, buddy. You know, we agreed to 20 bucks. That kind of sucks that you doubled the price on me, but still an amazing deal. I beat out the other seller, even though that person was in his town and whatever. So anyway, these are all pretty good games, except one of them kind of sucks. I don't remember which one. I think it was this one, the Yu-Gi-Oh game. If I remember right. Oh, by the way, I paid $40 for 9 of them. When I worked it out, they are basically $4.44 or 45 cents each, something like that. So that'd be all right. It's a little high on this one especially, because this one was only worth, like, I think with shipping, maybe $8 to $10. So it's like a $4.95 plus shipping or something like that. But the others are really good. Okay, so it's Pokemon XD. I looked them up again today because I was trying to remember last year when I sold one, it was about 40 bucks. I looked them up, and yeah, they go from about 35 to 45 bucks just for that one game. And it's totally complete. Excellent condition, not ripped up, not scratched up. Has the manual, the game. These are all complete. So that's pretty cool. This one, Metroid, I don't quite remember. It was probably between $15 and $20, somewhere around there. These Harvest Moons, I when I was looking up comps, I realized they're called the same thing, but they look different. They're Harvest Moon. Now I see the difference. One is called Harvest Moon A Wonderful Life. This one is Harvest Moon Another Wonderful Life. Okay, interesting. But either way, they're still complete, the disc, the manuals, all that kind of stuff. If I remember right, these are about the same thing. They were maybe 12 to 15 or maybe a little higher plus shipping. So free shipping, maybe 18, 20 bucks each, something like that. But I don't know for sure, but I'm guessing A Wonderful Life and Another Wonderful Life is kind of like part one, part two. So I'll probably bundle these together. I think I'll try that and see if I can sell them for like 40 bucks, somewhere around there. Maybe 40 plus shipping, something like that, just to make that sell happen a little easier. Okay, this one right here, pretty much anything Mario does pretty well. Again, totally complete. This is Mario Superstar Baseball. I'll have to look at it again. I don't remember if it was like 12 to 14 plus shipping or if it was more 15, 20-ish, something like that. That's pretty cool. Okay, then we got the Herbs Sims in the City. I think it's the same thing, around 15-ish or so, somewhere around there. Harry Potter, this one kind of sucked too. It was probably, I don't know, $12, $13, $14, somewhere around there. Maybe $15, $16 free shipping. Don't quite remember. And then we have Pokemon Coliseum. I think this was $20 to $30, somewhere around there. So for $40, it's still a good flip. And it kind of sucks that they're all a little over $4 a piece, but it'll be all right. Okay, so then when I left there, I went to Goodwill and I was looking around and I found some pretty cool stuff. So the very first thing I found was some tennis rackets. Now I've bought tennis rackets in the past for like 50 cents or a dollar at a garage sale and they totally sucked. They were terrible. And I ended up just donating them and taking the dollar loss. But these, I know this one is good. I think this one is good. I don't know anything about tennis, but I know some rackets can do well. They were both $3 at Goodwill. And I looked this one up. And one thing I learned is that inside the little section right here, it says what it is and all that. But anyway, this is a Prince brand. It's a, I think it's called the White 100. And then inside it has more details on like the weight and all that kind of stuff. Here we go. It's the TX239A-100. It's probably the model number. And anyway, I looked this up and I saw some. They were selling, I believe, for like $45 plus shipping. So that, to me, that's a good racket flip. I know some people might pass on them at that kind of price and they want rackets that are, you know, $80, $100, whatever. But man, around here, it's not the wealthiest area ever, so $3 into maybe $40 plus, somewhere around there, plus shipping. That's a pretty good flip. Now this one, it was $3. When I looked it up, I kind of found comps, but not the exact one, so I might lose my $3 on this, or I don't know, just sell it locally for $10 if it's no good or whatever, make a little bit of money on it. But I'm not sure. It's a Wilson, but it's the, where did I see it? A K reactor or a no K factor sorry I don't know. Anyway, I looked it up at Goodwill. I thought I saw some for around the same price, $40 something, but I could be totally wrong in this because I didn't find an exact comp, so it could be a total bust and no good at all. I don't know. Also, this one needs a new hand grip on it, so I'll have to double check that. It could be a total bummer in, I don't know, I'll sell for $5, $10, something like that. Just get my money back. I'm not sure. Okay, so then I walk around the rest of the store. They had a couch and a love seat. They were in good condition. They were already sold. That kind of sucked. And then I walked around some more, saw a couple of things that were like new in the package, but they were only going to sell for like, they were asking 12 and it's going to sell for like 20 something. Figure after fees, I don't really know if I want to make like $8 on it or whatever. So I pass, so then as I'm walking up to the register, I look in the glass display case where they have the good stuff, and I found some things. All right, so this right here was wrapped in cardboard, had a $2 price tag, and from the handle, I knew what this was because I've sold several last year. $2, I knew this was a great flip. Immediately, I recognized that this is a Cutco knife, all right, and of course it is. And it is a Cutco 3721KN. All right, made in USA. Cutco knives are, if you know what they are, you know what they are. But if you don't know what it is, it just looks like some crappy knife. But these are under the radar. These are good money. All right. So this one, it just looks like, you know, some steak knife you just throw in your drawer or whatever. But apparently these were like promotional giveaway knives. And I did notice that this one has a phone number and a select realty group. So it's like a real estate agent got this for who knows what, selling something, or maybe they gave it to new homeowners. I don't know. It has a phone number and that on there. It might hurt value, but I looked this up, this particular model, the 3721KN, they sell between 45 and 60 bucks. All right. So it would be really nice. I saw several going for about 50, 55, but because mine does have the engraving and it's the brown handle, I saw some are like red handles. I'm going to look at around 40, but I could be surprised if it goes for more. I don't know. Okay, now this thing was really cool. All right, so it's $15. It was in the, well, they had it out of the case, and here's what they had sitting out. All right, so it's just laying in the case like this. I was like, what in the world is that? Is that a flashlight? And then I look at it closer, and I asked to open the case, and then when I did, I verified that this was a Cutco knife, which it was. And then I saw this thing, and I was like, whoa, okay, wait a minute, that's pretty cool. So then, let me get it here. All right, so then I'm looking at it, I'm like, that's the thing the doctor uses to like look in your ears and in your eyes and all that. And anyway, they opened the case and I asked if I could look at it. And of course it has that. So I think this thing is for your ears. And I think this is for your eyes. I'm not totally sure. I can't even think of what it's called. I looked it up on eBay. But anyway, it's 15 bucks. So I thought, man, that could be really good money. So I looked it up. And it's really, really good money. So I decided to buy it. The brand is Welch Allen, W-E-L-C-H, and then Allen is spelled A-L-L-Y-N. I think it is an otoscope and a, how do you pronounce that? Ophthalmoscope. But anyway, you know, when you go to a doctor and they do a checkup, it's what they use to look at you. But anyway, just the two little heads that go on top. If I just sold those, they sell for, people are buying them for about $62 with free shipping. But since I have the full kit in the case, I found one that I believe is identical to it. I saw several that were similar. The ones that were similar were like $129, $150, somewhere around there. But I believe, here, I'll turn it sideways so you can see. I believe this is exactly what I have. Check that out. I don't know if you can read that, but it sold, yes, is that yesterday? Wow, okay, it sold yesterday for $255. That's an amazing find. They had 12 bids. But, yeah, that's exactly what I have. It has a hard case, mine's a soft case. So, I mean, I don't know if I'll get $255, but, I mean, here we go right here. Here's another one right here. This one's mounted to the wall. But it went for $153.50 right under it. So I think I can at least get 100, probably around 150 at least. But I'll try to go for more. Okay, so I need to speed this up because I only have a little bit of time to go to the post office. But I have this one more item here. You probably have figured out what it is by now. It's awesome. Okay. Sold these last year, one of my favorite flips ever. Goosebumps books. Alright. Last year I found them at a garage sale, paid $5 for a box, about half this size. Alright. And I didn't know anything about them. I just kind of looked them up, and Goosebumps books. I was like, okay, yeah, that's when I was a kid, you know. I remember people buying them at like the school book fairs and things like that. And anyway, I looked them up, and then since there was a bunch, I was like, well, if I just sell them as a lot. And then I looked them up as a lot. I was like, whoa, okay, these are like serious money. So then I looked through them, and at the first set I bought at the garage sale, they had just the original series, and it was 1 through 60. Two, I think, but it was missing about 9 or 10 books. So I had 50 something of the 60 something that they had in the first run. So I look them up and they were going for like really good money. I ended up selling them. I'll have to look back and verify when I edit this video, but I think they sold, I think it was like $164.95, something like that, if I remember right. But anyway, so I found these on Facebook Marketplace yesterday, and it said Goosebumps books, $40. I thought, okay. So that's, you know, that's no $5 buy. That's 40. Now I wonder if these are original ones or not. So anyway, I was like, you know what? Doesn't matter. It's, he says there's 84 books here. So it's got to be good money if, you know, even if they're like newer ones for 40 bucks, I should be able to double my money, maybe sell them for 100 bucks, something like that. That'd be a good flip. So I went and met him. And I mean, I just drove straight over. As soon as he said they're available, I drove straight to him so no one else could get them. And I checked them out, and they are the first series. And it's complete, all right? And I have more than just the first series. Now, I did notice on eBay comps that they said they have numbers 1 through 63. I was almost positive it was only 1 through 62. So I need to verify if there's supposed to be a number 63 book, because I have all the books 1 through 62. So I don't know if there are 63 or not. But I also have, I think it's 21 other books. So they made a series, let's see if I can find it here. They called it Series 2000. So the original books are from the early 90s, and apparently these come out, I'm guessing, in the 2000s. Another thing to look for when you do Goosebumps books is they might have stickers in them or posters or, I don't know, maybe 3D glasses. They have like little insert things, basically, what you want to look for. So the Series 2000 is, yeah, there we go. I think it's 1998. So basically, yeah, around that era. So they're, you know, about 10 years after the others come out, somewhere around there. So anyway, I got the first 1 through 62. I need to verify if I need 63. It might be worth going ahead and buying a number 63 for 10 bucks or whatever if it bumps up my value. But that plus the extra bucks, I should get some serious, serious money. So let me find my... I took a screenshot of that as well, because they can do really, really well. Okay, here we go. Check this out. This says 63 complete set Goosebumps, all original book series, plus extras. And they sold them for $399 plus shipping. And here's one down here that sold for $425 free shipping. That is awesome. That is a killer find, all right? So I paid 40 bucks. That's why I'm saying if I have to end up paying 10 bucks, maybe 15 to get number 63, if that's what I need to do, it'd be totally worth it. Turn 40 or maybe 50 bucks into $450, something like that, because I have more books than these people had because of the extra series. And there's also like a hardback one, and there's even one that has, which might have good value on its own. Let me see if I can show it to you. If I can get to it here. This right here is kind of cool. It is a postcard book. So it is just Goosebumps. Basically, they are postcards of the covers of books. So that's pretty cool. So to have all this, I'm just going to sell it as one lot. I think I might be able to get top price for all Goosebumps books. So the highest I saw was that, what was it, $425. I'm going to see if I can ask maybe $450, $475. I mean, I don't know. We'll see. But anyway, that's awesome, awesome flip. So very, very happy to find that. So anyway, I need to get booking and get my things ready to ship out, because I've got 20 minutes before a post office closes, and it always takes a while to run the labels and all that kind of stuff. So let me do that real quick, and then hopefully this week is going to just take off with some awesome sales, more awesome finds. It seems like the season's starting to ramp up now, so this is pretty cool. Okay, so it's Friday. I had a couple of sales on eBay. Also, this morning I found a couple of garage sales. So I hit them up. I found something at both of them. Then I did some thrifting, and I bought something at each thrift store I went to, too, as well. So that's pretty cool. So I think things are starting to pick up again. I've found a lot of stuff this week, so that's good. Okay, so first item that sold is a game, disc only, but I actually had a leftover case from another game. So I threw it in there, but it's an Xbox 360 Left 4 Dead. And I got this, I think, when I bought an Xbox 360 that had a bunch of games last year. And I sold off the Xbox 360 with some games. I sold off other games that I thought would do pretty well on their own. This is one of them that I thought would do okay, and it just didn't sell. So I eventually put it down to my get rid of it price, which was $7.95 with free shipping. So it's going to cost me probably like around $3, maybe a little more, a little less to ship. So I'll make a few bucks. But I have it left over. All my money come back. So I'm just considering it free anyway. And, you know, sell it for $7.95, make $3-4, whatever it ends up being. Okay, second item that sold is one of the games I just bought the other day for GameCube. This one is the Yu-Gi-Oh! The False Bound Kingdom. And this is the game that I said sucked and wasn't worth that much, but it was the first one to sell. But it was, I think, my lowest priced item I was able to put up. But anyway, this is part of the 9 games I bought the other day. For $40, what I did is I divided up the two best valued games, I decided to consider $6, and all the others I'm calling $4 just to make the math easy on my records that I keep. And anyway, this sold for $15.95 of free shipping, and I believe that was my lowest price game. I might have had another one about that price, but I was also making them pay shipping. But anyway, not too bad, and it sold pretty quickly. I just listed all of them last night, so it went pretty quick. It was complete, but it just, I don't know. One of the games I had, I mentioned I sold one last year for like $40-something. I think it was like $42.95. I looked it up, and now people are selling them for about $55. So I actually have that one listed pretty high, and we'll see what happens. But if that one sells, it will pay for everything I bought the other day, plus profit, and then all of these would be pure profit. So that'd be pretty cool. So anyway, I need to go ahead and get these mailed out. Then I'm going to hit up another sale today. It's kind of an afternoon, evening sale. And then there's actually another one about 30 miles away that I might check out because it looked like a pretty large church gymnasium sale. And some of the stuff they're showing looked interesting. So I think it actually might be worth checking out. And I think I mentioned that I went garage selling this morning and found some stuff. And also went thrifting and found something at each of those thrift stores. Well, I'll show that to you later. I don't have time to do it right now, but I found some pretty cool stuff that's worth pretty good money. So anyway, hopefully I can find some pretty cool stuff at the other garage sales tonight, and then I can show you tomorrow. All right, so now it's Saturday, and I had a couple sales overnight, and I went to a garage sale today that wasn't that great until the end. I found some stuff, and anyway, I'll just pile all that in with all the other stuff I bought yesterday, and I'll show that to you later, but right now, I want to show you these, and I got to run to the post office real quick. Okay, so first item sold is some of the GameCube games I just bought the other day. These two are called Harvest Moon, but this one is called A Wonderful Life, and this one is Another Wonderful Life. So I'm assuming part one, part two, something like that. They didn't have like crazy value on their own, but since I had two of them, they were 75% complete. The A Wonderful Life has the manual and all that kind of stuff, but the manual cover's like ripped in half, and the other one does not have the manual. So I couldn't get top dollar, but what I decided to do was sell them together and almost get top dollar. So anyway, like I said, with all those games I bought for $40, I divided it by 9. My two best games were gonna be $6, and then all the rest are 4. So I'm considering these 4 each, so it cost me $8 for these two games. And they sold for $34.95 with free shipping. So it'd be a pretty good flip. Second one's the best one. This is the whole reason I bought that lot of games. Oh, by the way, it's for GameCube, if I haven't mentioned that. Same thing with this, it's the other GameCube game. This is the one I knew had value. This is a Nintendo GameCube Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. I sold this exact game last year for, I think, $42.95. So I knew that when this guy was only asking $20 on Facebook, and then even after he kind of backtracked and was like, well, I'd like double what I'm asking, I knew that this game would pay for it. But when I posted this, or listed it on eBay, they were going for even more money now, all right? So I was able to list this for $54.95 free shipping, and it sold in a day, all right? Or a little over a day. So that's pretty awesome. So I have, this is one of the good games, so I considered it $6 on its own. It sold for $54.95 free shipping, and that is pre-owned, so that's awesome. That is a really, really good game to go after. For whatever reason, people like, well, of course they like Mario, because when you think Nintendo, you think Mario, but they really are into Pokemon. That stuff sells great, and kind of the whole Japanese anime-type games and all that seem to do really well. So anyway, that was the sales today so far. Like I said, I'm going to go take them to the post office. And then when I get back, I'll show you all the stuff I bought. I found some amazing things and really, really good start to the very first week of garage sailing. All right, so here is all the stuff I picked up over the weekend from garage sailing and going to some thrift stores. So it seems like the season has officially kicked off because I actually found some pretty good stuff. I guess we'll just start here in front. These shoes here are Clarks, which can be a decent brand, probably not for this style, but I thought I'd try them out. I was thinking these were $4.50, but then when I went to pay for them at Goodwill, they were $9. So that kind of sucks because they don't bring like crazy money. They probably will go for around 30-ish. So that's why I thought, oh, after, you know, less than $5, turn in 30, that's good enough for now. But I ended up paying 10. Okay, on the other hand, these shoes right here, which I need to clean up, these women's Nikes, they were, I'm trying to remember, how much did I pay for those?
it was either $225 or $350. I don't remember which now. But anyway, these go for, I think about the same, somewhere around 30, maybe 35, something like that. Okay, these right here are Doc Martens. I found these at a rummage sale, only paid $2 for them. Those are probably about $30 or $35 as well. I need to clean them up and make them look a little better. Put some shoe polish on them and all that kind of stuff, make the scuffs go away. But for the most part, they're actually in pretty good condition, not too much wear or anything. Okay, these right here are Bostonian shoes. I've sold some before. I've also taken a loss on some, but these seem to be in really nice condition. And I'm trying to remember why did I get these? They were $2, I think, if I remember right. But when I looked them up, I think, yeah, they're 12, there we go, they're 12 men's. I think they sold for like around $50 or something like that. So I thought that was a really good flip. And I found them at the very first garage sale of the year. So that was pretty cool. Okay, this right here is an old lens. I got this at Salvation Army. Paid $25, so I kind of paid up for it, but I think it'd be worth it. But it's this right here, it's a Minolta, made in Japan. There you go, an MC Rocker PF, and it's a 114 F58 millimeter. I looked these up, they kind of range all over the place. Some of them, of course, none of them that I saw had the case. And then I believe that like this rubber thing is an extra part. So the ones that had extra parts, but I did not even see a case, some of them were going for like $50 to $70, something like that. So I want to try to go on the high end because mine, it seems to be really clean and in good condition. So, you know, maybe I'll make a $40 or $50 profit on that, something like that. We'll see. Okay, this right here is pretty cool. Found another plane model. When I think of old planes, I always think of a P-51 Mustang. And I actually found one and it's still sealed. The part that kind of sucks is that the box is crunched a little bit. And I paid a bit much for it, but I still think it could be a decent flip. This was at the second garage sale of the year. I ended up paying $10 for it, which is kind of high, but I want to see if I can get a little more money out of it. It seemed like they were selling for around $25, $30, maybe $35, somewhere around there. So I'm going to see if I can maybe turn it into about $30, but it would have been nice to have gotten it cheaper. At that same sale, though, I did find this, which is pretty cool. It's a leather bag. It's like a briefcase, all right? And you may be thinking like, why in the world did you buy that thing? It's all like kind of dirty. I think that is a reason to buy it. That really awesome worn patina is kind of in. Kind of like everyone's into the farmhouse style right now. I think they're into like patinaed leather and all that kind of stuff too. And is that the same sale? I only paid, how much was it now? Was it a dollar? Yeah, I think it was a dollar if I remember right. So anyway, that was really, really cheap. And I looked these up. I mean, I couldn't find one exact. I couldn't even find like a brand on it or anything like that. But I'm going to try to ask maybe $50, $60, $70 for it, somewhere around there. Just go really high. Maybe put a best offer, maybe free shipping. Try to entice some people to, you know, give me some offers and I'll just take one. But that should be a really, really good flip. Okay, also, you're seeing four wheels here. These are chrome wheels for a little Ford Ranger. One of them I think said 2000, so I'm guessing that's when they're from. And I got these at Habitat for Humanity, and it was only $35 for all four of them. That's pretty awesome. And they are chrome, they're a little dirty, a tiny bit of rust in spots, like those spots right there. But I actually have a way to clean them and make them look really good, and I can actually get rid of that rust really easily. I have a video on my DIY Dork channel that shows how to clean little rust spots like that off of chrome and make it look good again. So I'm gonna do that trick, and maybe I'll link to that video at the bottom of this one. But anyway, for $35, I mean, I don't know how many people are really looking for Ford Ranger wheels. I know some of the older Ford Rangers had 14-inch wheels. These are 15s by 7s, so it's a little bit bigger wheel. And of course, they're chrome. You see some of these out there sometimes that are just like painted gray. So maybe someone out there will pay $100, $125, something like that. So not quite make a $100 profit on it, but pretty close. Okay, let's see, what else? We'll go over here. Okay, so today I hit up a garage sale this morning and I found three items, all local flips and some more furniture and another bike. So this right here, I thought the hexagon trend is still kind of in. and it was only $3. And it's got that cool kind of, like I was saying, that kind of worn farmhouse look or whatever. So for $3, I'll see if I can sell that for about $15, $20. I'll probably ask $20 and see what happens. Okay, also got this kind of a half moon shaped table. I'll clean it up. They were asking $5, but I got it cheaper. Try to remember what the deal was. So I bought these two tables and the bike for $45 total, but they were asking $3 on that, $5 on this, and $50 on the bike. So I actually got a really, really good deal. So anyway, on the table, I don't know, maybe I'm trying to think, maybe I considered it $3 and that was $2, and I'm considering that $40 because I only paid $45. So I'll turn my $3 probably, I'll probably ask $30 and see what happens. Probably take somewhere around $25, $30. That's a decent flip. And I also found this, it's a Schwinn, but it's kind of interesting. They're asking $50. I was able to work it down to $40. It's in good condition. I just need to clean it up, air up the tires. I want to try to at least double my money, pay $40, see if I can list it for $85, $90, somewhere around there, and see what happens. Probably sell it for $75 and above, and hopefully it'll go quick. Okay, also, and those were from this morning, but last night, I went to a church rummage sale, like an evening sale, and then afterwards I went to Goodwill and I found some cool stuff. So at the church rummage sale, let me move some things real quick. Found a couple interesting things. All right, first off is, I think it's oak, and this is a cutting board. It's pretty big. You can tell it has some age to it. I think I'm gonna clean it up, probably sand it a little bit, and then re-oil it with some mineral oil. I only paid $2 for it. I've never tried selling something like that locally, but I think I can make it kind of interesting, and because it's so big, and I'll see if I can get maybe $20 or $30 out of it. Be kind of interesting. Okay, also I found these, which I'm just kind of experimenting. I didn't really look up comps, but I just have a feeling they could do well, especially since they have a case. All right, both open here. But what they are is tons of cassettes, vintage 80s cassettes, like Guns N' Roses, Motley Crue, Poison, Skid Row, Bon Jovi, Madonna, Heart, Aerosmith, Kiss, Whitesnake, all kinds of stuff. This one's a little bit mixed, but anyway, they were selling cassette tapes for 25 cents each. They just counted them all up. I don't remember how many there were, and they just let me have the case as well, and I paid $14 for all that. So I think what I'm gonna do is basically just sell it as is, like this lot right here, just sell it as is. This lot, I have more cassette tapes, I can add to it. I'll just sell it as is in the case, and see if I can get, I don't even know. I mean, what could you get, maybe $1 or $2 per tape? So whatever that is, however it works out, maybe $40 plus shipping, something like that. And see what happens. So that'd be kind of cool. Make about maybe a $25 profit on each one, something like that. So that could be pretty good. Okay, also at that sale, I found this. Another leather bag with some patina. This one did have a brand on it. It's called Cortez, and it is made in Colombia. And I looked this up. I couldn't find an exact match for this style, the attaché or briefcase, whatever you call it. But I did see some vintage Cortez bags that were selling for around $50 plus shipping. So I think I'm going to do the same thing as that one. I'll ask high. Maybe I'll ask $75 or $80 free shipping. Maybe put best offer on there and just see what happens. But I paid $1 for this as well. So that was pretty cool. Now that I think of it, I think I paid $5 for that one, and then this one was $1. But either way, they both can go really well. Okay, so then after the rummage sale, I went to Goodwill, found a couple things that are interesting. All right, so these tassel shoes are Tommy Bahama. Now I know that some Tommy Bahama shirts can do well. I've had a couple, one did pretty decent, one not so great. So I just looked these up and I was surprised. So I paid, okay, these said they were $9, but it was blue, and apparently blue was on sale for 75% off. So I paid $2.25 for these shoes. And anyway, when I looked them up, now the one problem is these are men's shoes, but they're nine, which is kind of small. But I did see a pair that was, were they men's size 12 or 13? But they were pre-owned, and they sold for $84.95 or 80, somewhere around $85. And I thought that was awesome. Okay, so I was willing to pay $9 to maybe get, you know, that. But then when I went to the register, it was only $2.25. Now, I think mine are, I mean, they're not bad condition, but they have some scuffs and things like the other pair did not have. although the other pair was still pre-owned. So I don't really know. It could be a total bomb, goes for like 25, 30 bucks, but I'm going to try to get 50 or 60 something, or at least ask that and then see what happens. All right, and then the last thing was the absolute find of the weekend. This is really cool. I have never heard of this before, but something about the box told me to look it up. It just looked interesting. And they were only asking $15 for this at Goodwill. It was in their glass case. And when I looked it up on eBay, I was blown away. All right, so what this is, the brand is Involve Audio, and it is a Surround Master, some type of upgrade for surround sound system. But check it out. When I open it up, it has some new stuff in there. So looks interesting. I don't really know how to test it or anything. But anyway, I'll have to see if I can edit in a picture. But when I found sold comps, when I looked up sold comps, there was one that sold a month ago for $355, and it was pre-owned. So I guess I will consider this pre-owned because it's open and not completely sealed, but then the cables are sealed. But I'm thinking the way that everything fits in the box that, I don't know, maybe these go underneath, but I don't know. It definitely doesn't fit that way. But I'll just have to look into it. But this may be new, unused. I have no idea how much they cost new. But I did see one sold for $355. So maybe I could get that, maybe more, maybe a little less. But for $15, that is an awesome, awesome flip. So anyway, that was what I found over the weekend. Now I got to clean everything up and get it ready to start posting and see what happens the rest of the weekend. Okay, I also forgot when I come home from the garage sale today that I went by Goodwill and I found some more stuff. And again, it's not like super high dollar things, but it'll bring in some money. It's decent. So this right here is Legos, still sealed. Problem is that people have tried to scrape off the price tag and it kind of messed up the box. And it's, I don't know where it come from exactly, but I paid $5.99. I looked them up and they sell for about 25 to maybe 30 free shipping, something like that. So I'm not sure what I'll do with this one. It probably would do best to go ahead and put it on eBay. But I might try selling it locally and see what happens. I've never tried selling Legos locally, but I'd ask maybe 20 or 25 bucks and see what happens. And then I might end up making a little more money than on eBay due to like eBay fees and all that kind of stuff. But I'm not sure people are gonna buy this type of thing around here where I live, but I don't know, we'll see. Okay, and also I've bought these shoes, and after I just looked at the price tag a minute ago, I realized they charged me too much for them. These are women's shoes, but they charged me men's shoes prices. At our Goodwill, women's shoes, like tennis shoes and all that are $350. They charge me $450. These are Skechers, not really a great brand, but they're in pretty good condition. The one thing about these is maybe they're kind of small. They're 6.5 women's, I don't know. But they are work shoes, so they are, if I remember right, yeah, they're steel-toed. And I looked them up and they were selling, I think around $25, $26, something like that, plus shipping. So we'll see what happens. But anyway, that was all of the finds for the weekend. So like I said, I'll get them cleaned up and get them listed. And hopefully I can get the furniture to move this weekend, possibly even the bike.
Okay, so the weekend is now over. I had several sales on eBay. I also had a pretty good local sale. So I'll show that one to you first. And of course I have to put a picture up because I already sold it. But it is the Sega Dreamcast video game system. I bought end of summer, beginning of fall, somewhere around there. And got it at this garage sale where I actually bought a bunch of stuff from the guy and only paid 30 bucks for it. It was the system, all the cords and power cables to hook it up. It had two controllers, a little zapper gun thing, memory cards, and then it had about 5 or 6 games. I don't remember how many now. But anyway, I brought it home. It was in a box. It just kind of sat there for a while. Oh, I'll get to it later. Well, you know how that goes. It sits around and you forget about it and something gets piled on top and then you can't remember what's in that box. And anyway, I should have listed it a long time ago, way before Christmas, but I didn't. So within the last probably 2 months or so, I was like, you know what? I remember I bought that thing. I need to go ahead and list it because it's probably pretty good money. So I looked on eBay. The prices were okay. You know, they were, I don't know, $70, maybe $100, something like that. So I thought, well, you know, I paid 30 bucks, so I don't know. Let me look at it a little closer. So then I went through all the games, and two of the games were worth separating out separately. And I listed them on eBay. They should bring somewhere around $25, maybe $30 each. Somewhere around there, maybe. We'll assume somewhere around $25 bucks. So I pulled them out. So if they sell, they will pay for the full system. And then when the system sells, you know, it's all pure profit. So anyway, I decided to go ahead and list it locally first just to see what happens. And then that way I don't have to deal with wrapping it all up and getting it ready for shipping and all that kind of stuff. So I decided to list it pretty high locally at $120. That was higher than I probably could have gotten on eBay, or maybe, well, I probably could have asked about 100, maybe a 120, but locally I went 120 because I knew I was probably not going to get that. I assumed I was going to get offers around, you know, 75, 80 bucks, and then I decided if I wanted to take it or not. Well, it was up for several weeks, I don't know, three, four weeks, probably something like that. And finally, over the weekend, this lady said, I would sure like to have that. I'd offer you $100 if you could bring it to me. So I thought about it, I was like, you know what, that's probably about max what I would get out of it on eBay. And that's not including fees I'd probably have to pay and all that. So I'd probably make more if I go ahead and do that. And if I go drive it over to this lady, she lived in the town where the Goodwill that I found all the awesome stuff this week is. So I thought, you know what, I'll go there, then I'll go by the Goodwill, see if I can find anything. So I took it up and sold it to her for 100 bucks. I made $70 profit off of that. And I have the two games that should bring about 25-ish each once they eventually sell. So that's actually pretty good profit, pretty good turnover for 30 bucks. And when I met this lady, I was really surprised. She was this little old lady, probably 80-something years old, not at all who I'd expect to be into video games, but she was really excited about it. So apparently she's wanted one for a while. I don't know, kind of interesting. Also, her Facebook profile, everything that popped up on her wall was all like Facebook games. So she was really into gaming, just not someone, I mean, you look at her, you would never think that she was into video games like that. Okay, so that's a local sale. As far as eBay sales, I just have them written down on here. We'll go smallest to biggest. So first one, I think I showed this recently. It's the Vizio remote. All right, so I've had this one sitting around in a box for a while downstairs. I bought it at this, I think the very first garage sale I ever went to in 2017 with the intention of buying things to sell, to resell. And I just loaded everything up into a box and then they just kind of gave you a price. I think I paid $5 or $10 for everything that day. And anyway, I looked this up, and these little remotes, they're for like the soundbar, Vizio soundbar systems. And anyway, it sold for $11.95 free shipping. So it's actually a pretty good turnaround. Okay, next item is this right here. It's another remote. This one is a Pioneer. It's the CU-VSX093. I just bought this within, what, the last week or so at Habitat for Humanity. It was $1. And anyway, it had pretty, for a remote, it was pretty good value on eBay. And it ended up selling for $21.95 plus shipping. And they paid $3.74 shipping. So it's a total of $25.69. I paid a dollar. They almost paid $26 for this remote. So that's pretty cool. So neither of these fit my $30 and above that I've been trying to do for the last year. But these sold quickly. They sold in less than a week. They sold within like 4 or 5 days of listing. So that's pretty cool. Okay, the other two things are two more of the GameCube games. That purchase off of Facebook Marketplace that was supposed to be $20 and then the guy doubled it to $40 still paid off. I'm now over $100 in profit after fees, after shipping, all that kind of stuff. So the first one that sold, let me find it here, okay, is the Mario game, Mario Superstar Baseball. All right, so this is one of the games that was like not the highest profit one I could get, so I considered it $4, and it sold for $15.95 plus $4.49 shipping, so that's a total of $20.44, and I have $4 in it, so that's pretty good. And the second game that sold was my second highest profit game. So I already sold the Pokemon XD, the one that last year I sold for $40 or $42.95, something like that. This year, the one I just sold went for $54.95. I was very surprised about that. Well, here is the other Pokemon game, the Pokemon Coliseum. And this one sold for, okay, and since it's a higher profit one, just like the other one, I'm considering it $6. Because I paid $40 for 9 games. This one sold for $36.95 free shipping. So that brings me down to $30.95 after purchase cost. Shipping's probably going to be about $3-something, and I'll pay some fees. Probably make a little over $25 profit on that. So somewhere around there. Okay, and then just a little while ago, I sold something that I almost deleted off of eBay. I wasn't sure they were going to sell because they were a little rough. I've dropped the price quite a bit on them, and they still sold, and I'll make some money. What that is this right here. These are vintage Boy Scouts of America. Well, here we go. Boy Scouts of America National Council. They're like vintage hiking backpacks, but look how grungy they are. Okay, they're pretty trashed out. This one's missing some leather straps, but they are vintage. They're probably, I don't remember now. I was thinking they might have been 50s or 60s, but I could be wrong about that. I found these at a garage sale. They were laying on the ground, and they were only asking $1 each. So I gave them $2. I didn't even look them up. I just assumed, you know what, they're bags, they're canvas, they got a cool look, and they're Boy Scouts. There's probably someone out there that would want them. And then, I brought them home. I looked them up. They didn't quite have the value I thought they would, and mine were way grungier than all the others. So I think I originally had them at like 30-something bucks for both of them, and I eventually dropped it down to $19.95 plus shipping. So they ended up selling for $19.95 plus $8.71 shipping, which is a total of $28.66, I believe. And I only had $2 in them, so I'll pay some fees off that $28.66. I don't know, I'll make probably a little under $15 on them, something like that. So yeah, you make a little money, but not quite as much as I thought. So anyway, that was the flips and finds of the week. It was the first week of, I guess I can call it, garage sale season. It seemed to have kicked off. I found something every one of them that I went to. Some of the things I bought were like, it could, if it sells, it will bring good profit, but I'm not sure how good of a seller it would be. And then other items that, like these video games, the GameCube games I got off of Facebook Marketplace, were really awesome. And even thrift stores, I was finding pretty decent stuff. It's been so long since I found anything this year, and finally everything's just kicking off. So I have tons of work ahead of me this week, getting everything ready, and photos and listing, all that kind of stuff, kind of ramping all that back up. But should be pretty well. So anyway, if you like these videos, go ahead, give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment of what you think. And then if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and do that to keep up with more of these videos. So anyway, thanks for checking it out.